Hello and welcome to Super Return Asia 2019. Coming to you from Hong Kong, I'm Sarah Clark, and I'm joined by Ruchira Shukla, the Regional Lead of South Asia, Venture Capital IFC. Thanks for joining us.
Glad to be here.
Let's look at the subject of manager selection in venture capital. What are the key areas you should look for when you're identifying a good, solid VC manager? What might be three key areas?
So for one, we always look at what sectors or subsectors the fund manager wants to invest in, and have they invested the time to research those areas? Do they understand the underlying trends and dynamics? And do they have an original, insightful thesis? As well as their ability to stick to their thesis. That becomes, you know, one of the primary factors. The other one would be their reputation. The reputation amongst their peers, the reputation amongst founders. Because some of the best deals are very hotly chased, and the ability to attract those deals is going to be a function of how well you're perceived in the market. The third thing that's important to us is institution building. We look for fund managers that are not just for one fund. They're trying to build an institution. We can see a series of fund come out of that GP, and a strong indication of that is how well they're building their teams. Is there a next level that is ready for partnership? Is that next level of talent able to help on boards and in nurturing the portfolio companies?
Okay, you mentioned performance being one of the key areas. How do you analyze a manager's performance, or how do you dissect the best performance?
So to us, performance is less about the metrics, although we do see the metrics. We look at MOIC, TVPI, DPI, the kind of metrics most LPs would look at. But it is a lot about the quality of the portfolio. Because the metrics sometimes don't tell you the whole story. The metrics are as good as, you know, how good the last valuation may have been. But for us, because we also have a large direct investing business, we spend a lot of time on the underlying sectors ourselves. We spend a lot of time with the companies. We meet the CEOs, understand the challenges and how they've been overcome. So the quality of the underlying portfolio and also the pipeline that the manager is looking at, for us, that is what performance means. And we look at it over the long term. So it's not just over a short term. I would sometimes track GPs whose underlying portfolio is familiar to us for almost 2 years before we think that it's a fit with our strategy.
So is past performance a guarantee that you're going to get a good VC
No,
manager?
Not a guarantee, but a good indication of at least how well the GP thinks about the space, how disciplined they are in making their selection, how well they manage and guide their portfolio companies, as well as how disciplined they are about monetizing on time.
So investing in managers that have had a good past record, hoping that past record will repeat itself.
Hoping for that, although I must point out that especially in venture, trends and dynamics change all the time. A sector that's very hot today may not be relevant tomorrow. A new sector may come into being. New industries are getting created. So we obviously, the fund manager will then be tested against a new set of parameters. So while it's a strong indicator, the past is not a guarantee.
Is it good to invest in a manager who has had a diversity of experience with regards to the different sectors?
Yes, certainly. So we like to see a sectoral focus in terms of a few sectors of importance, not just a single sector. So diversity with a few sectors. At the same time, we don't like somebody who doesn't have a thesis. So you've got to have a thesis and know the sectors you're going after.
And crucial to evaluate the life cycle of that manager.
Yes, absolutely. Because in the short term, this is a long-term game. So you need to wait it out and see how the manager does throughout the life cycle, yes.
Is it tempting to limit a manager search to large organizations?
Well, not for us. So I can see that some LPs would be tempted to do that. It's sometimes an easier way of decision making, but I have found very high quality managers among some of the smaller funds, new GPs coming into the market. And for IFC, a big focus is what we call market creation, which means in the venture capital space, are we creating a market? Are we there supporting the creation of new fund managers? And that is why we don't always get swayed by large organizations. We support new managers.
Okay. What's the biggest mistake most first-time venture capital fund managers make? And how can you avoid this? How would you advise on avoiding this?
There are a couple. So the first one I would say is chasing the hottest sector out there, going after the one deal that everybody else wants to go in. And my advice for that has always been, what's your own conviction? What's your own thesis? If it falls within your thesis, by all means. But otherwise, let's not chase the latest fad, because in high probability, that won't last. The other mistake they often make is being too focused on the day-to-day and not building that next bench of talent. not nurturing the junior people in the fund to become partners of tomorrow. And the problem with that short-term thinking is, as soon as your portfolio expands, the one or two main GPs are stretched too thin. So, you know, we constantly counsel them on encouraging the next tier, the next level, to go and take board roles, to work with portfolio companies, and advise on building the strategy so that they can be ready to take the fund on in the future.
Ruchira Shukla, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Thank you for joining us. And if you'd like to see more conversations like this, you can follow us on Twitter. Look for hashtag SRAsia. See you next time.